Hello there! Welcome to this video. Let's get a complete overview on all the features inside Microsoft OneNote 2019 and see everything you need to know to start with it. Visit our YouTube channel and our official website for more news, tips, and extra content on all the products we cover. Microsoft OneNote is the perfect product to write notes, drop sketches, and store information in your computer, tablet, or smartphone with a very simple and essential workspace similar to a digital copybook. Starting from this 2019 release, OneNote does not require any Office subscription since it is installed as a free app on Windows 10. Does not work on older versions of Windows. And in case you own a Mac, you can download this product for free directly from the Mac App Store. The main OneNote workspace is very simple. On top, you have the toolbar, collecting all the features and tools available. On the left, the navigation panel, with all the notes saved inside OneNote. And on the right, the big preview where you type, draw, and link files. The navigation panel shows the basic structure of each document inside OneNote. The notebooks are big collections of colored chapters called sections. Then, inside each section, you have all the pages with notes, drawings, and attachments inside. You can click on any notebook or section to open it and select any page to show it on the main preview. At first, OneNote has a default notebook with pages showing several tips and suggestions, explaining how to use the product. You can create new notebooks, sections, or pages by right-clicking on any empty space or using the plus buttons at the bottom. All the changes and modifications made on any OneNote document is saved on the cloud every time you see a sync icon on any notebook. You can adjust the cloud settings by going to the last button on the right and then to Settings, Options. You can manage your notebooks, sections, and pages by right-clicking on these in order to rename, delete, or change their color. To adjust their order, just click and pull one up or down. Let's see how to work with the pages. A new page is completely blank, showing creation date and hour on top. Type above these to rename the page and give a title. Then click anywhere on the preview to fix the pointer and start typing. In addition, you can open the View tab to set the page appearance, such as its background color with page color and its layout with rule or grid lines. You can adjust the zoom level on the page by holding down the Control or the Command key and using your mouse wheel. You can also work in full screen mode by using the arrow button in the top right corner. As you work on the page, you create independent objects called notes, containing pieces of text, links, tables, and also file attachments within a gray contour. Let's check these in detail. When typing inside a page, a text note is created, collecting the whole paragraph within its gray contour. You can use the Home tab above to adjust the text properties, such as font, size, style, color, and alignment. These changes are applied on a single word where your pointer is placed. You can click on the gray contour on top to select the whole text and edit it entirely. You can also add useful tags on each text line by using the Tags button inside the Home tab. These include general icons and also a to-do symbol that you can mark as completed by clicking on it. Use Create New Tag to create a custom tag instead. You can also use the Insert tab to import extra content inside the page. Use Symbol to add special characters. And Link to add clickable hyperlinks on pieces of text. Use Table to import a table with a defined number of rows and columns. Then click on any cell to type inside. These get adjusted according to the text content automatically. But you can set the cell's size on your own by clicking and dragging their borders. In addition, you can use the Table section to adjust the table layout, adding or removing rows and columns, and adjusting the color of the cells selected with shading. Click on Hide Borders to hide or show the cell borders. Use File to browse and import attachments inside your page. These are added as simple notes with their name and icon within the gray contour. You can open these files by double-clicking on these. Whereas, use Pictures and PDF to add images and PDF documents with a complete preview open on the OneNote workspace. You can import tables, files, and pictures within an existing text note in order to keep these linked within the contour. Just go to a new line and import the content with the tools inside the Insert tab. You can use the tools inside the Draw tab to draw on the page freehand. Enable the pencil, the pen, or a highlighter, and click once again to set the trace radius, its color, and style. Then click and drag on the page to make your drawing. You can also use shapes to drop lines, regular shapes, and graphs by clicking and dragging on the page, or ink to shape and ink to text to transform your freehand drawing into the closest shape or text matching it. Use Eraser to remove any drawing by clicking on it. Now, let's see how to manage all the notes and objects inside the page with the Select tool on under the Draw tab. This gets enabled also in case you disable the current tool with the Escape key. You can move text, tables, and files by clicking and dragging from their gray contour. You can also use the arrows in the top right corner to adjust their content distribution. To move pictures, PDF documents, and drawings, just click and drag these. Use their white nodes to scale and use the Picture tab to rotate and flip pictures and PDF documents. To cut, copy, paste, or delete any note, just right-click on it. You can also use Order to adjust the order of visibility when multiple objects overlap. Remember to use Control or Command and Z to undo any action if you make a mistake. To move and scale multiple objects, enable Lasso Select under the Draw tab, and click and drag on all the interested notes to select them. Then you can apply your modifications on the whole group. To export your OneNote document, use the Share button in the top right corner, adding the email address directly or sending a copy via email or Skype. Whereas to print the current page, section, or notebook selected, go to Print on the extreme right, setting orientation and page size. Thanks for watching this video. Check our guide link inside the video description for more and free content on Microsoft Office 2019.